Hello everyone. In this video, I will do a functional test of the analog multimeter Hioki 3030-10. If you wish to get a closer look at the physical aspect of this multimeter, you may want to watch my other video that I linked below. Testing for AC voltage. I have here a 230 volts 60 Hz residential power supply. I will set the function selector to 300 volts AC range, one notch higher than the expected output voltage at this outlet. That's a reading of 230 volts. Since the 300 volt range position was chosen, I'm going to read the value at the 30 scale. So 23 multiplied by the ratio of 330, which is 10, is 230. Testing a 9 volt battery. Turning the function selector one notch higher than the expected voltage to be measured. Here I will select 12 volt range position and read the value at the 12 scale. Connecting the positive test lead to the positive post of the battery. I'm getting a reading of 8.2 volts DC. For this 1.5 volt rated AAA battery, select the 3 volt range and read the value at the 30 scale. That's 1.6 volts DC. This is to be expected, as this is a brand new battery. This is my setup for testing the DC range function of the Hioki 3030-10 with regard to the output voltage of my 60 watt solar panel, Bosca solar panel. This is the back of my 60 watt Bosca solar panel, and this is the nameplate and the nameplate ratings. As you can see, the rated open circuit voltage, the maximum open circuit voltage, is at 22.32 volts. Since the maximum open circuit DC output voltage of this solar panel is rated at 22.32 volts DC, I will set my function selector to the 30 volt DC range position and read the value at the 30 scale. Connect the positive test lead to the positive terminal of the Bosca solar panel and the negative terminal of the Bosca solar panel to the negative test lead of the analog multimeter. I'm getting a reading of 20 volts DC. The output of the solar panel will always depend on the position of the solar panel itself and the time of the day and the amount of sunlight that actually hits the solar cells. So a reading at this time, at this very moment, of 20 volts DC at the terminals of this solar PV panel. That 20 volts DC reading is acceptable. The solar panel is therefore working as it should. The 1.5 volt battery tester. This is one convenient feature of the Hioki 3030-10 analog multimeter. With this, you can quickly and easily tell if a 1.5 volt battery, whether AA, AAA, size C or size D, still has enough charge left. This is made possible because the battery under test is burdened with a low 10 ohm impedance, essentially putting the battery under a loaded condition, which will reveal its true state of charge. The result is visual. We use this lowest black scale. We can tell if the battery has enough juice left in it if the needle falls within this big bold line. If it falls within this thin line, it means it's time to replace it. If it falls inside a big bold line but more to the left, like this rechargeable battery, then it means it's time to recharge this battery. But if the needle rests at the center of that big bold line, or even more to the right, like this AAA battery, then it means that the battery is new or has nearly full charge left in it. Resistor test function, or the ohmmeter function of a multimeter. The symbol for the ohmmeter function is the unit of resistance called ohm, this one here. And we read the value of the resistance in the upper red scale of the analog display. Before testing the resistance of the resistors, connect the tips of the test leads together and adjust the 0 ohm adjuster knob to ensure that the resistance of the test leads start at 0. The rightmost position of the ohmmeter scale. Resistor number 1. That's 10 ohm. That is exactly 10 ohm because the multiplier is just 1. 100 ohms. The next is almost at 500 ohms, and since it's quite difficult to read, I'll move the function selector to the next multiplier, which is times 10, and repeat the procedure of zeroing the resistance of the test leads. Repeating resistor 3. That's 46. Since our multiplier is 10, 46 multiplied by 10 is 460. So resistor 3 is 460 ohms. Resistor 4. It is reading at 1K mark. I'll change the position to times 1000 and repeat the procedure again of zeroing the resistance. Repeating resistor 4. 100, it's reading 100, since our multiplier is 100 also, that's 10,000 ohms or 10 kilo ohms, which is the correct rating of this resistor actually. The LED tester at the X10 range. This is used to test whether the LEDs are in good condition by lighting up. Now the polarities of the test leads when it is at the ohmmeter function is reversed. The positive end of the battery inside the multimeter is connected actually to the black test lead, while the negative end of the battery inside is connected to the red test lead. So we connect the black test leads to the anode side of the LED. If it does not light up, just change the position of the test leads. If the LED will not light up, regardless of the orientation of the test leads, then you must investigate further as there might be something wrong with the LEDs themselves. So LED 1 lights up just fine. Number 2 as well. Number 3. Number 4. Number 5. And number 6. According to the user's manual of the 3030-10, we can ignore the reading of the needle as it swings when testing for the LED light. How much voltage is actually across the test leads of the analog multimeter? We can test that by measuring the output voltage using a digital multimeter like this Fluke 116 set at the DC voltage range. That's 3.172 volts. So there's actually 3.2 volts across the terminals of the test leads, and that's the one responsible for lighting up the LEDs. The Hioki 3030-10 does not have a dedicated continuity function, or a continuity buzzer, or a continuity light. But by simply placing it at the X1 range position, we can still test for continuity. What is continuity anyway, but simply a means by which we can determine if a circuit component can complete an electric circuit. Here are some of the 500 milliampere fuses that I bought online from Lazada for one of my analog clamp meters. I will test them for continuity. The first one is busted. Second one is good. Third one also good. This is also good. The last one is no good. Simply using the X1 range position of the analog multimeter, I have tested for the continuity of these fuses and discovered that two of them are useless. They were already busted when I bought them. Although it may not be immediately apparent in the actual setup, this is simply the connection diagram. This is my DC power supply. It is supplying power to the LED light, which is connected in series with the Hioki 3030-10 set at the range of 300 milliamperes DC. The test leads are connected in series with the load and the DC power supply, with the red test lead going all the way back to the positive terminal, the black test lead going back to the negative terminal. This is now the actual setup of the demonstration for the 300 milliampere DC measurement range of the Hioki 3030-10. Since I'm using the 300 milliampere DC range, I'm going to read the value at the 30 scale and multiply all readings by 10. Right now the needle rests at 16, so that's 160 milliamperes. Essentially the same reading as shown by the DC power supply. So this simple demonstration shows that the DC measurement function of the Hioki 3030-10 works just fine. I like the Hioki 3030-10 analog multimeter for its simple design and robust construction. It has a very clear and well laid out functions surrounding the function selector, very clear analog display with big characters and easy to read analog scales, high quality test leads which are removable, also a very good accessory like this carrying case. It is also only recently manufactured. This unit was made in Japan last May 2022, barely 4 months ago. Some of the limitations of this analog multimeter is that it is limited to only times 1000 in the ohmmeter range. It does not have the extra convenience features of continuity buzzer or continuity light. There are other analog multimeters which have more functions and features than the 3030-10, but if you're looking for basic functions and a multimeter that does those basic functions well, you may want to look at the 3030-10. This one is rated at category 3, 600 volts, and that's not a bad thing either. I'd appreciate your comments and suggestions. Thank you for watching.